Hello everyone, it's Shannon here for Waffle Flower Crafts. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make a really sweet card using the new Sweet Ice Cream stamp set. Here are the products that I'm using today. First up, this is the Sweet Ice Cream combo set. So this is the Sweet Ice Cream stamp set as well as the Sweet Ice Cream matching die. So when you buy the combo, you get the dies and the stamp set. I'm also going to use the apartment builder die as well as the A2 grid panel die. I've already gone ahead and die cut all my components I need to create my little ice cream shop. I first die cut this panel using the A2 grid panel die. I did it out of some turquoise cardstock. Out of white cardstock, I die cut 3 windows and an awning using the apartment builder die, as well as 3 curtains from peach cardstock and 3 balcony pieces from some light pink cardstock. I really like the look of 2 awnings layered on top of each other, the bottom one slightly offset. So I will cut another awning here from this pink cardstock that you see inside my Misty. But before I cut this awning, I'm pointing out here that the die cuts these little pleats in the awning, and I want to actually stamp my sentiment first. It's a little bit easier to stamp your sentiment first before those pleats are cut and then cut it out. So I'm just have the die there to kind of help me gauge how much space I have to fit that sentiment in. I pulled off my sentiment from the Sweet Ice Cream stamp set, and I'm going to kind of position it here at an angle. And then once I get it positioned the way that I like it, I'll pick up those stamps and stamp it on this pink cardstock in Memento Tuxedo Black. And then I will die cut this once the sentiment is stamped. I'm using Memento Tuxedo Black because the images that I stamp later will be Copic colored, and I want to have the same consistent black ink throughout the whole project. So I'm inking this up and stamping it a second time here just to make sure those letters are nice and clear and crisp. And now I will die cut that awning out. I'm going to center my awning die here and then grab some purple tape to hold it in place. And then I will run this through my die cutting machine. And again, the only reason why I stamped it first is just because it's a little easier to stamp that sentiment before those pleats are added than after. And there's the awning. This will be at the top awning, and then we'll have that white awning underneath it later when we construct our scene. So now I'm going to move ahead. I've already stamped in Memento Tuxedo Black all the images. I'm going to Copic color here on some white cardstock. I've got my Copics on screen here. And I'm going to play some music and let you guys follow along while I color, and I'll meet you back when I'm almost done. Okay, I'm back. I'm just finishing up this vanilla scoop with a little G0000. Just add a little shadow. And now all my Copic coloring is complete. And I'm now going to die cut them out with the matching dies. I'll grab one of the mice here so you can see how nicely those dies cut the images out. And I am now going to move on to creating a background for my ice cream shop. So I have an A2 panel of white cardstock, and I grabbed Waffle Flower dye ink called You Said What. This is a really pretty yellow color, and I'm going to blend it at the upper portion here, just kind of creating a gradation so it's darker at the very top and getting lighter down towards the center. This is just going to add a little bit of warmth behind the windows of the ice cream shop, make it look like there's a light on the inside. This is just a nice little additional touch. I'm going to add a little bit more here. I am using a mini ink blending tool to blend this out. But this is really simple blending. Does not have to be a very seamless or perfect blend, because a lot of this will be covered by windows and the mice, and so you don't have to stress about blending for the background here. I've got my A2 grid panel. I'm going to tape in that inside section there, the large rectangle piece. And I am going to now glue these curtains in place. I'm just going to use some Tombow Mono multi-liquid adhesive here and just going to glue them to this upper row of cardstock. I actually make a little mistake here, and I glue these curtains down first. I'm going to cut the middle section of six of those squares later to kind of make it look like a big, three long big windows, and then they'll fit that window frame, which I have over there on the left. You can see now I'm grabbing my scissors here to cut out those middle window sections. I probably should have done that before. Should have done this before I glued those curtains in place, but it's okay. At least I remembered before I glued that frame down, which I almost did. I almost glued that right white frame down before I cut these. And I'm just using a pair of scissors just to snip and trim that off. And again, these don't have to be perfectly trimmed, because the frame will kind of cover a lot. So just kind of snip them off so there's as flush with the rest of the die cut as possible. And now I'm just going to use some more Tombow Mono multi-liquid adhesive here and glue down the window frames as well as the balcony pieces. So there's the railing. I decided to glue these first, and then I'm going to glue the white window frames slightly over the balcony. So I wanted to put these down first. So now that I've got all the balcony pieces in place, I now finally am going to glue down those white window frames. And again, I cut all these earlier just out of different colored cardstock just to save me a step of blending. You could, of course, cut these pieces out of white cardstock and blend over the white cardstock to make it the colors that you want, instead of using colored cardstock if you want to avoid using colored cardstock. Okay, so now you can see here the double awning, or the layered awning, that I want to create. I want that white layer to kind of poke out a little bit underneath the pink. So I'm just figuring out where I need that white layer to go. And now I'm going to put some glue down, and then I'll glue the white layer right down on top of the card base, or the panel. And for the pink layer, I want it to have a little dimension. So I'm going to grab some foam tape here, and I'm going to place a piece of foam tape right at the bottom of the awning. I'm going to trim this down a little bit. I don't want this huge piece. I want it a little bit thinner, because I want it to have like this nice gradation. So I'm going to actually glue the top part of the awning down flush onto the panel, but the bottom part of the awning will be a little bit of little raised. I just like the look of that. It has a nice like seamless look, because you don't see the cardstock up, or the foam tape up at the top. And I'll just glue this down here, and I removed the backing on the foam tape, but I'm gluing the top directly down onto the grid panel. There we go. So now my whole little shop scene is constructed, all put together. I'm now going to flip this over. Once here, I'm removing a little bit of glue that I got kind of squished out at the side. And you can see how the blended panel adds a nice warmth behind the shop. I'm going to take some foam tape now and add foam tape all behind the panel except for right under the window. So I have a little bit of space here to play with the mice and get them where I want. So I went ahead and removed all the backing on the foam tape, and now I'm just going to, sorry about my head getting in here, going to stick that panel directly down onto an A2 top folding card base. And now I'm going to grab all my mice and my ice cream cone pieces and kind of position them where I want them to go in my little scene. And once I have them where I want, I'm going to grab some foam tape and start adding some foam tape to the backside of the mice and the ice cream cone to stick everything down. So this card is actually very similar to a card I created a couple of releases ago. I used another Liz My Tinger set called Grow Happiness. That set also has little mice like these here, but it has a garden theme. I used the apartment builder and kind of constructed this apartment scene where one mouse was serenading the other out of her window. It was a cute little scene, but I never created a video for it. So when I saw this new sweet ice cream stamp set by Liz, I knew that I wanted to create an ice cream scene or an ice cream shop with the apartment builder die, because I never showed you guys how I constructed that scene, and I just couldn't resist making an ice cream shop for those little mice. So I just finished sticking down all my die cuts, and now I have to adhere my panel down onto my card base. So I have an A2 top folding card base, just put some liquid adhesive on the backside of my panel, and then stuck my panel directly down onto my card base, and that will complete my card. I really like how this card turned out. I think the sweet ice cream set would be so fun for so many different scenes, a great birthday set, and I just love the versatility of this apartment builder die. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you want any more information on the products I use, please visit Waffle Flower, and you can follow us on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook for more creative ideas. Thanks for watching.